हॅलो स्टुडंट्स, आय एम डॉक्टर निलेश कोहली, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर, सांगोकाना ठाकूर आर्ट्स कॉमर्स सायन्स कॉलेज, न्यू पनवेल ऑटोनॉमस, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ अकाउंटिंग अँड फायनान्स. टुडे आय एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इंटरनल रिकन्स्ट्रक्शन. दिस टॉपिक इज रिलेटेड टू द फायनान्शियल अकाउंटिंग 5 फॉर द बी कॉम अकाउंटिंग अँड फायनान्स प्रोग्राम. हियर वी आर गोइंग टू बी डिस्कस द मीनिंग ऑफ रिकन्स्ट्रक्शन, ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ रिकन्स्ट्रक्शन, प्रोसिजर फॉर रिकन्स्ट्रक्शन, टाइप्स ऑफ रिकन्स्ट्रक्शन, methods of internal reconstruction, accounting entries and the preparation of the balance sheet. Now first we'll discuss about the meaning of the reconstruction. Reconstruction is required when the company is incurring losses from the main years and the statement of affairs or the financial statement does not reflect the true and fair position of the company, which is due to the overvaluation of the asset, fictitious asset, intangible asset and profit and loss account debit balance, which is reflected into the balance sheet asset side. The company shows higher net worth and not show the true picture of the financial position. Reconstruction is the process of the company's reorganization of the capital structure by revaluation of the asset and reassessing the liabilities. The purpose of reconstruction is usually restructuring capital or to compound with the creditors of the company, which leads to come out from the present situation of the company which is overcapitalized without winding up the existing company. So here the important aspect is that we have to compound the creditors of the company, they are the debenture holders of the company. Objective of the internal reconstruction: it resolves the problem of the overcapitalization, overvaluation of assets and accumulated losses. As we know that in internal reconstruction the valuation of the asset has been overvalued and the there is an accumulated losses are there which has not been offsetted against the profit because the company has been facing the losses. So here the main purpose of the internal reconstruction is to write off the accumulated losses. Overstated asset, it means the asset has been overvalued, so that has been adjusted or that has been write off. Then intangible asset and fictitious asset by reducing the capital. It also the reassess the liabilities of the company. It raised the fund by issuing the equity share for running the business and settlement of the creditors of the company. It reduced the share capital of the company and to bring its real net worth. So it presents a true and fair view of the financial statement. So that is important. Now procedure for the internal reconstruction. So as we know here, see, first procedure is it should be authorized by the articles of association. Then the special resolution has been passed. Then it has been passed with the tribunal. Then the registration has been made and the finally publication. So here one by one we'll see that authorization of the articles of association. The articles of association contains the aims and objective regarding the internal affairs of the company, and it mentions the clause containing the manner of reduction of capital. The company must be authorized by its article of association to restore for capital reduction. So it is very important that it should be authorized in the articles of association, and the company must pass the special resolution before resorting the capital reduction. So special resolution can be passed only if the majority of the stakeholders are assenting to the internal reconstruction. So this special resolution must be signed by the tribunal and submit to the registrar appointed under the Companies Act 2013. Then permission of the tribunal, the company must get the permission of the tribunal before starting the process of the capital reduction, because ultimately here the asset has been overvalued, the reassessment of the liabilities are there. So therefore anyhow the liability holders or the creditors of the companies are there who are going to be suffer. So henceforth the permission of the tribunal should be there. Then confirmation and registration. Section 66 of 3 of the Companies Act 2013 said that if the tribunal is satisfied that either the creditors have been consented to the reduction or the dates have been determined, discharge or paid or secured. It means there should be consent from the creditors that they are ready for that, to offset or to give up their claim. Also to some sort of the or to the certain extent of that there is a discharge or the payment made towards the debenture holders of the company. So the company shall deliver a certified copy of tribunal order confirming the reduction together with the minutes giving the details of the company to the registrar. Publication of the order. Section 66 of 4 of the Companies Act 2013 said that the order is confirmation of the reduction of share capital by the tribunal under subsection of the 3 shall be published by the company in such a manner that the tribunal may direct. So if the directive which has been given by the tribunal and accordingly the there should be publication of the order made. Now further we'll speak about the types of the internal reconstruction. There are the two types of the reconstruction, that is an internal reconstruction and the external reconstruction. We already discussed about the internal reconstruction. It is the process which affairs of the company are reorganized by revaluation of the asset, reassessment of the liability, and finally writing of the losses already suffered by reducing the paid up value of the shares or varying the rights attached to the different classes of the shares. This part we will discuss later on. Then section 61 and section 66 of the Companies Act 2013 deals with the internal reconstruction. So these two sections are very important in respect of the internal reconstruction. External reconstruction, where it involves the winding up the existing company and the transfer all the assets and liabilities to the new company formed for the purpose of the taking over the business and undertaking of the existing company. So here the important aspect is that shareholder of the existing company, or which is called as the transfer company, become the shareholder in the transferee company. So this concept has been used here. So this is like in the merger, the business undertaking, the shareholder of the transferee company are substantially same as those the transfer company. So external reconstruction is regulated by section 232 of the Companies Act 2013. Methods of the internal reconstruction. First one is an alternation of the share capital, then variation of the shareholding rights, reduction of the share capital, compromise and arrangement, and surrender of shares. So one by one we will see that. First, alteration of the share capital. So here the company is alter their share capital. So section 61 of the Companies Act 2013 is there. Now how the alteration of the share capital has been made? The first part is an increase in the authorized capital. Now company get the authority or the permission from the register of the companies and increase their authorized share capital. So that will be used to issue the new share capital for raising the fund. Then consolidation of the shares and subdivision of the shares, conversion of shares into stock and vice versa, and cancellation of the unissued shares. Now consolidation of shares. So if the consolidation shares to of conversion of the share into the smaller denomination into the shares of the larger denomination. So for the understanding purpose, I have given the example. NK Limited is having the 10,000 equity share of rupees 10 each, decide to convert equity shares of rupees 100 each. So here the thing is that the number of shares is 10,000 and the face value of the share is 10 rupees. Now this share has been converted for rupees 100 each. So here the value of the share is increased, that is from 10 to 100. So this is called as a consolidation of the shares, where the exactly what we are doing, that smaller denomination of shares converted into the larger denomination. So previously the number of equity share capital was 10,000 equity shares of 10 each, that is 1 lakh. Now after consolidation of the shares, there will be 1,000 equity share of rupees 100 each for rupees 1 lakh. So here the important part is that the amount of the share capital will not change. This is the same as it is. This is not changed. Only the change in respect of the change in the value of the shares or value per shares, henceforth the number of shares has been changed. So this is a change has been incurred. So this is called as a consolidation of the shares. Then the subdivision of the shares. In subdivision of the shares, conversion of the shares for larger denomination into the smaller denomination. It is opposite to consolidation of the shares. So example is given, VK Limited is having the 10,000 equity share of rupees 100 each, which has been converted in equity share of rupees 10 each. So here we do have the equity share capital, that is 10,000 equity share of rupees 100 each, and the amount is 10 lakh rupees. Now the share has been subdivided, and here the value per share is previously it was 100, now it is 10, and because of that the number of equity share has been increased, that is 1 lakh, and the total share capital is 10 lakh. So here see students, the total share capital before conversion or before subdivision it was 10 lakhs, and after subdivision it was 10 lakh. Only the changes has been incurred in the number of equity share, that is previously it was 10,000 shares, now it is 1 lakh. It means the larger denomination into smaller denomination. So this is called as a subdivision of the shares. Then conversion of the share into stock and vice versa. So according to section 61 of the Companies Act, the company can convert its fully paid shares into stock. So important part is the fully paid shares. The share should be fully paid. That only shares can be converted into the stock, and again that stock can be converted into the shares. So reconversion of the stock into shares. So example is given, SK Limited had 5000 equity share of his 100 each, which decided to convert into stock. So the equity share capital is there, that is the 5000 equity share of rupees 100 each, and the amount is 5 lakh. Now this conversion of the equity share is there, so the equity stock is there, so equity stock, that is the amount will be 5 lakh. The total amount will not be changed, only it was previously equity share capital, now it is the equity stocks. So here the journal entry is if you pass the journal entry, the journal entry will be equity share capital account debit to equity stock. So this journal entry has been passed. Then again, suppose this same equity stock has been converted into the equity share capital, so the entry will be reversed, that is the equity stock account debit to equity share capital. So this entry will be passed in the case of the conversion. Then the accounting entries in this case of that, first is in alteration of the share capital, issue of equity share is there, where the bank account debit to equity share capital, this entry is passed. Consolidation of the shares, equity share capital to equity share capital, previous we have to give the effect of the previous one, and later on the amount is not going to be changed. Again the subdivision of the share, equity share capital account debit to equity share capital, and conversion of the equity share into equity stock, so equity share capital account debit to equity stock. Then conversion of the equity stock into equity shares, so equity stock account debit to equity share capital. So see, these two entries are there which has been interchanged. And for cancellation of the unissued share capital, suppose the company is having the share capital, but the company has not been issued the share, so in that case the entry is not passed in the books of account. So here students, we have discussed in respect of the alteration of the share capital, that is in a first method of the internal reconstruction, where it consists in the 5 parts, that is in a first one is in a increase in the share capital, second one is in a consolidation of the share, third one is a subdivision of the shares, fourth one is a conversion of the equity share into the equity stock and vice versa, and last one is a cancellation of unissued share capital. Thank you.